Each year, counties that get housing and urban development funding must complete a count of all homeless people living in the area. WAND's Carly Bronkema takes us behind the scenes of the annual point-in-time count in Springfield.
Tracking the number of unsheltered people living in Sangamon County.
We're going to kind of divide up areas of the city, and we're going to send you all out. Our goal is to get you out on the street by about 8:30, and we want to encourage you to take your time. Again, the goal is to not rush through this, but the goal is to actually connect with people.
Each year, dozens of volunteers help with the point-in-time count, which tracks the number of people needing housing in Sangamon County.
And our goal is to basically be confident that every person that's unsheltered in our community is known by name.
Volunteers spread throughout the county.
That's the west side of Springfield, anything west of MacArthur.
And fill out surveys with unhoused people.
How many times have you stayed in a shelter or in the streets in the past 3 years?
A couple of times.
A couple of times. Like maybe one, two, maybe three.
Heartland Housed says the goal is to see what resources are still needed.
It's a key part of our planning. As we look at this number and we see it alongside the data we have every day through our system.
So besides housing, what else would you need assistance with?
Last year, volunteers counted 306 unsheltered people living in Sangamon County. Outreach organizations say the results help ensure each person is well cared for.
Have you ever been contacted by a street outreach caseworker?
No.
This is your first time?
Yes.
Okay.
The interactions are at around 10 minutes if a person is willing to go all the way through the survey with us. And oftentimes our volunteers are also just trying to hear what a person is experiencing and what services they might be open to.
In Springfield, Carly Bronkema, WAND News.
Sangamon County's point-in-time count was completed last night, but preliminary results must be checked with shelters and confirmed with Housing and Urban Development before they're released.